Yeah, we're in the thick of it. Hey, gearheads, and welcome on back to the NASCAR Thunder 2003 career mode. I'm Alan Bailey. I had to think about it there for a second. Cool weekend out at Darlington over the weekend. Throwback weekend is so much fun. I hope all the moms out there had a great Mother's Day weekend. We are in race number 4 of 36 here in the career, year number 1. It is the calendar year 2002, so yeah. Just so that we have a little context right now. The first three races, Dale Jarrett got another 500 victory. Kevin Harvick won out at North Carolina, the Rock, Rockingham. Then out at Vegas, Ricky Rudd came home with the victory. We're heading out to Atlanta. Yeah, I'm hoping we could turn things around, and then we're going to Darlington. So later this week, we'll go to Darlington. And then Bristol. Bristol, I have high hopes. But 32 laps out at Atlanta in this video. The standings so far, we're 24th. We only have one top 10, and 8th place finish is our best finish so far here in the rookie season for Bailey Auto Sports. We're 200-plus markers back. Right now, Dale Jarrett is your leader. Ooh, look at Junior. Only a few points out of the fourth leader. I don't know. Jeff Burton, 3rd. Kevin Harvick, 4th. And Ricky Rudd, 5th. Yeah, this is cool. This is cool. I'm digging it a lot. We are battling for Rookie of the Year, so we'll go ahead and head on out to the MBNA America 500 at the Atlanta Motor Speedway. Let's go.
MRN welcomes you to Hampton, Georgia, site of today's NASCAR Winston Cup race, the MBNA America 500. I expect to see some exciting racing in this one, don't you, Barney?
NASCAR doesn't use restrictor plates for this track, which is actually why it's one of the fastest speedways in the Winston Cup series. We may see some speeds hit 200 miles an hour just before they dive off into these corners.
The GM Goodrich Service Plus Chevrolet will go for yet another top 10 finish at a speedway in this one.
Well, that's right, and I think he will have an excellent run in this one as well. I spoke to the crew chief this morning, and he assured me that they have a very fast hot rod.
The 64 car hasn't performed well at the speedway tracks this season.
And a good finish would go a long way in boosting that team's morale. I guarantee it would make a whole lot easier to come to these racetracks.
Tony Stewart will begin the race in the top 5 in points.
Gaining on the leader is tough when you are in the top 5 in points. It takes you having a good race and the leader having a bad one in order to gain anything substantial. See how they'll line up for the start.
In the front row are the GM Goodrich Service Plus Chevrolet and the 63 car. In the second row are the America Online Chevrolet and the Singular Wireless Chevrolet. Starting the race from row 3 are the Motorcraft Ford and the UAW Delphi Chevrolet. The fourth row has the Kodak Chevrolet and the Altel Ford. Dale Jarrett, the season point leader, will begin this race in 10th.
Easy. Good buddy. Green flag.
Going underway at Atlanta here, just outside the top 20. So, Texas, Terry, I'm so sorry. And I'm in a Hendrick Motorsports sandwich. All of them are back here. All right, that's interesting. Something I failed to mention is that we're waiting for the engine upgrade, which is coming after this race. So, we'll have the engine upgrade after this, and we'll build out a better car after this, and start repairing the cars so that they're a little bit better. Tony owes me. I don't mean to get into Tony as much as we are, but that's just what's happening, apparently. It's the second race in a row I've gotten into Tony. Wrecked him in our last video, unintentionally.
Okay, okay. Oh, sorry, Jeff.
I barely touched Jeff right there, and that was it. Got a little tight. Car's not bad, it's just, it's a little tight. Copy that. We're a little tight, a tick tight, especially in 3 and 4, but we're lacking the horsepower, which is what is really hurting us right now, so. Whoa. Who is this, Shauna Robinson? I think it is.
Wait.
Okay. Yeah, I eagled a little bit right there. I'm fine. You know, it's just car's not that great. Got a decent little run through there, so car's super unstable. Cool. Car's super unstable on the straights. However, there's a nice little decent little cushion in the corners. It's just once we get off the banking, it gets the rear end just wants to eagle. So, holding on to her. Oh, great. Here's Terry and Tony. See what I did there? Oh, man. This was right around the time that... Absolutely. This is right around the time Terry Labonte fell off the face of the earth career-wise. He started going down. He got a win in, I want to say that was 04 at the Southern 500 after that, but nothing after that. Basically, as soon as they put Tony the Tiger on the hood of his car, he started not doing great, basically.
You're looking great from where I'm sitting. How's the car feel?
Tight in the turns. Loosen me up a little bit. Yeah, we're in the thick of it. Car's not getting better as the fuel's burning off either. She's extraordinarily tight down here in 1 and 2. Just, I got it back way off. And even then, we're pushing. But we're up to 12th, so I can't really complain that much, you know?
A couple top 5 cars are on their way into the pits.
I had a feeling we were going to see pit stops right now. I'm going to go one more lap, and then we'll come in. Because I don't want to give up too much on these old tires, but we're 12th before the pit stops. We, a couple races ago, tried the strat of staying out as long as we could.
We're losing time.
Yeah, see, right there, we'll pit this time. Yeah, we tried the strat of going as long as we could.
At 41 car.
At Rockingham, and it killed us. We lost a lap, we were dead last, and we were running in the top 5 at that race.
So. 41 is still there. The 41 car wants to get by you. Clear all around.
What's the limit? 55? Oh, it's 70. Okay. Well, I was really conservative. I didn't want to speed. Loosen it up a scotch. Yeah, and they added that for this game, and it finally bit us. It took 4 races, but there you go. Mistake. So 19.
Look out. Traffic up high. Car up high. Everything okay with the car?
I just got back onto the racetrack. I mean, give me a lap or two to...
24 is exiting pit road ahead.
Everybody's exiting pit road. I'm coming up here. I don't care. Sorry, Robbie. Trying to hang on to. Okay. That's fine. 21st. Now let's see. We're going to get a couple spots right here. Oh, we're a lap down. Ooh. So someone's. I was about to just say it. Somebody stayed out. Don't know who it was, but they're in pit road right now, so we're going to hustle around here and try to get that track position back, try to get the lap back, because 20th a lap down, no bueno, I don't know, where was I going? Car's a lot better, by the way. I think it was the freshies.
The 31 car is still there.
Now let's see. Lap back right there. We're still 20th. That's fine. Just, I'm excited to be back on the lead lap. Oh, and there you go. Someone just took the lead. So we're almost a lap down, but we're hanging here, 20th. Once again, we lose spots on pit road, so it looks like pitting early is the winning strategy in this game. So we'll have to readjust to pitting early. So ultimately, that little fumble on pit road by my tire changer cost us 7 spots on the racetrack, but I feel like it definitely hurt us just with the track position itself, not just the spots, but
fastest we've been yet, buddy.
Cool. You see, we're 25 seconds back. We were like 10 seconds back originally, so I mean, that's ultimately what it was, is it was about 10 seconds on the racetrack, which is just so darn much. In reality, it was maybe 2 seconds on pit road, but you could see how it just translates. It's okay, though. We're a young team.
Right front tire's wearing down. Try another line or it won't last.
I this long into a fuel run, I don't know what else to do. But
that's it. That's the speed we're looking for.
A little slower that time, but okay. But no, we're trying to catch a couple cars here, but we've got a gaggle of cars behind us.
Fuel's down to half.
Happy? And everybody's just so spread out here, we're not able to get the draft here, which is not helping us. We're an underfunded rookie team. We're trying. This is probably not for a position. This is probably a lapper, if I had to guess. Yeah, Casey Kane in that 98.
You're looking great from where I'm sitting. How's the car feel?
It's okay. It's just slow. You know, you look at the mile per hour right there, which I admittedly haven't. We're doing 163 these turns, give or take. By the end of the backstretch, where are we? 175-ish? Yeah, 175-ish. Should be 190-ish. So we're very underpowered, but we're still on the lead lap barely. We're hanging out just inside the top 20, so see what we can get here in the closing laps.
Five, buddy. Five to go.
Copy that. And do me a huge favor. Make sure you mash that subscribe button. It truly helps us out a lot. Give us a thumbs up as well for hard-fought effort out here at Atlanta. It's finishing on the lead lap. Looks like we're going to finish on the lead lap. And make sure that you share the video with your friends and family, as well as on your social media accounts, to help grow the channel as well.
One to go.
Happy that. Man, you see it right there. Terry, and race is already over. Someone picked up the checkered right there. Oh, we'll tap the wall on the white flag, just because why not? But you see right there, Terry's all over our back bumper. It's a question of, can we hold on to this 18th? When did we jump up to 18th? I don't know, but oh man, he's going to get us. He's going
to
get us.
Easy on the bumping, buddy.
I wasn't proud of that, but 18th. Oh. I drove my butt off, y'all. That was the hardest. Oh, of course, Harvick wins in Atlanta. Good for him.
A rare caution-free race.
Yeah, and that can be physically exhausting to these drivers. Not only do the cautions give them a chance to catch up on the racetrack, it also gives both their minds and their bodies a little break. They've all got to be drained after that one.
We hope you enjoyed today's broadcast of NASCAR Winston Cup Racing on MRN, the voice of NASCAR.
So you see it right there, almost 300,000. That's a pretty good little photo for us right there. Kevin Harvick wins, Dale Earnhardt Jr. second, Ryan Newman third, Mark Martin fourth, Bobby Labonte comes home fifth. Let's check out the rest of your top 10 finishers as soon as we zip all the way up here. So you got Tony Stewart sixth. Jeff Gordon came back for a 7th place finish. Ricky Rudd finishes 8th, with Jeff Burton finishing 9th. Jimmy Johnson, in his rookie season, finishing 10th. Rusty Walrus coming home 11th. Kenseth 12th. Sterling Marlin 13th. Michael Waltrip 14th. Kurt Busch 15th. Jimmy Spencer coming home 16th. Bill Elliott 17th. We come home 19th. Or 18th, I'm sorry. Terry Labonte 19th. And Steve Park 20th. Let's see if there was any other. Ooh, the points leader coming home 22nd. That's notable. Any other? Well, there's a lot of big names back here. Yeah, Jerry Nadeau is in that 25 car. So problems for Jerry Nadeau, Kyle Petty problems as well, and Kasey Kahne finishing a lap down. I think we had a few, I think, finish a lap down. 31 laps? Yeah, we had 21 cars on the lead lap. We were one of them. So little progressions in the right direction here. I want to thank you so much for watching. You can subscribe to, well, yeah, mash that subscribe button, but also you can help support the channel by logging on to patreon.com/HeyAlanBailey. You can also follow me on Twitter, Instagram, and Twitch at HeyAlanBailey. NASCAR Thunder 2003, y'all. We're going to have some upgrades in the next video, the next few videos, actually, so make sure you mash that subscribe button and come right on back for the NASCAR Thunder 2003 career mode. I'm Alan Bailey. We'll see you at the track.